Once upon a time, in a faraway land, a young prince lived in a shining castle. Although he had everything his heart desired, the prince was spoiled, selfish, and unkind. But then, one winter's night, an old beggar came to the castle and offered him a single rose in return for shelter from the bitter cold. Repulsed by her haggard appearance, the prince sneered at the gift and turned the old woman away. But she warned him not to be deceived by appearances, for beauty is far within. And when he dismissed her again, the old woman's ugliness melted away. The prince tried to apologize, but it was too late, for she had seen there was no love in his heart. As punishment, she transformed into a hideous beast, and placed a powerful spell on the castle. Ashamed of his monstrous form, the beast concealed himself inside his castle, with a magic mirror as his only window to the outside world. The rose she had offered was truly an enchanted rose, which would bloom for many years. If he could learn to love another and earn their love in return by the time the last petal fell, then the spell would be broken. If not, he would be doomed to remain a beast for all time. As the years passed, he fell into despair and lost all hope. For who could ever learn to love a beast?
It's my favorite. I've got my sights set on that one.
The inventor's daughter?
Hey, that's the one. She's the girl I'm going to marry.
Yeah, but she's
the most beautiful girl in town.
I know.
That makes her the best. And don't I deserve the best?
Well, what'd you do?
Right from the moment when I met her and saw her, I said she's gorgeous and I found. Here in town there's only she who's beautiful as me. So I'm making plans to
primeval.
Why, thank you, Belle. What do you say you and me take a walk down to the tavern and take a look at my trophies?
What do you say we don't?
Oh, come on, Belle. I think I know how you feel about me.
You can't even imagine. Gaston, please. I have to get inside to help my father.
That crazy old fool. He needs all the help he can get.
Don't talk about my father that way.
Yeah, don't talk about our father that way.
My father's not crazy. He's a genius.
Papa!
Son of genius.
What's a genius?
Look, LeFou, I want you to go out into the woods and bring me back the biggest, healthiest deer you can find.
Not the woods. Anything but the woods. You know I hate the woods.
Just bring me a deer for my wedding feast.
But the woods are so dark and spooky and there's bugs and spiders and there's not so dear.
Papa, are you all right?
Oh, I'm fine, but I can't for life make figure out what happened. If this isn't the stubbornest piece of...
Papa!
I'm already give up on that hunk of junk.
You always say that.
I mean it this time. I'll never get that dog-headed contraption to work.
Yes, you will. And you'll win first prize at the fair tomorrow. And become a world-famous inventor.
You really think so?
You know I do. I always have.
Well, we better get cracked. This thing's not going to fix itself. Let me see. Where did I put that dog-legged clutch?
Papa.
So, tell me. Did you have a good time in town today?
Oh, I got a new book.
You do love those books.
Well, they take me away to wonderful places where there's adventure and mystery, romance, and happy endings. Papa, if I ask you something, will you answer me honestly?
Don't I always?
Do you think I'm odd?
My daughter? Odd? Where would you get an idea like that?
I don't know. It's just that, well... people talk.
They talk about me too. No, I'm not like you. No family ever seen her, except from uncles who, well, maybe not that best. In all you say and do, you couldn't make it plainer. You are your mother's daughter, therefore you are class.
except I'm simply not like them.
They are the common herd, and you can take my word. You are unique, creme de la creme.
Help! 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 shouldn't have let him in.
Could that be the Vosser wolves?
Is anyone home?
If we keep quiet, maybe he'll go away.
Someone there?
Not a word, Lumiere, not one word.
I don't mean to intrude, but I lost my way in the woods and I need a place to stay for the night.
Poor fellow. Cotsworth, have a heart. Monsieur, you're welcome here.
I heard that. I know there's someone here. And I'll thank you to step out where I can see you.
I know.
And goodbye. Isn't it? And quite inexplicable. Goodbye.
Cosgrave, I'm surprised at you. What are your manners?
We've got to get him out of here before the master finds out.
This is incredible. How's this accomplished?
Really, sir, if you would just... stop that. Stop it, I say.
Really, sir.
Come along now. anyone home? Hello?
Gaston, what a pleasant surprise.
Isn't it, though? I'm just full of surprises. For you, mademoiselle.
A miniature portrait. Of you. You shouldn't have.
Oh, don't mention it. You know, Belle, there isn't a girl in town who wouldn't love to be in your shoes right now. Today is the day your dreams come true.
What could you possibly know about my dreams, Gaston?
Correct. Massaging my feet while the little ones play on the floor with the dogs. Oh, we'll have 6 or 7.
Dogs?
No, Belle. Strapping boys! Like me.
Imagine that!
I can see that we will share all that love implies. We shall be the perfect pair, rather like my thighs. You are face to face with destiny. All roads lead to the best things in life. All's well that ends with me. Escape me, there's no way. Certain as doorway. Now when you marry. So, Belle, what'll it be? Is it yes or is it? Oh, yes!
I just don't deserve you.
Who does? Me!
Thanks for asking.
How'd it go?
Oh, you know that Belle always playing hard to get.
She turned you down?
For now. But I'll have Belle for my wife. Make no mistake about that.
Well, gee, if she turned him down, then maybe I'll have a chance. Don't even think, go!
Is he gone? Can you imagine? Me, the wife of that boorish ringer. Madame Gaston, can't you just see it?
Near the crossroads, okay?
happened to him. You have to take me back.
Not on your life!
Then I'll find him myself.
Couldn't keep quiet, could we? Just had to invite him to stay, didn't we? Serve him tea, sit in the master's chair.
I was trying to be hospitable.
Rubbish.
Ah, Cogsworth, can you blame me for trying to maintain what is left of our humanity? Look at us. Look at you.
What about me?
Well, you were always insufferable. But every day you become just a little more inflexible. A little more tightly wound. A little more...
Please, please, spare me the stupid puns.
At least we are not as far gone as some of the others. You saw it happen to Michelle.
She always was too vain about her looks, and that's exactly what she's become.
A vanity.
Little drawers mirror the works.
And poor Jean-Claude.
Who?
Jean-Claude, you remember him? Not bright, as dumb as a...
A brick?
It's a whole wall.
Jean-Claude's a brick wall.
That's him in the kitchen, behind the stove. And you know Guillaume, the houseboy?
That mealy-mouthed little bootlicker, I've never liked him. He's always groveling at the master's feet.
He's a doormat.
Perfect.
He's happening faster with some of the others, but we are not far behind. Slowly but surely, we'll all gradually become things.
But why did we have to get dragged into this whole spell business? It's not like we threw that poor old beggar woman out on her ear.
No, but are we not responsible, too, for helping to make him the way he is?
I suppose so.
All I know is I will eventually melt away to nothing. I hope there's something left of me if the master ever breaks the spell.
Hold on, old man. We've got to hold on.
Hello? Is anyone here? Hello?
It's a girl.
Yes, of course. I can hear it's a girl.
It's a girl! Mademoiselle.
Lumiere, let me do all the talking.
Woo-hoo.
As head of the household, I should do most of the talking.
Sally.
The word, just a word, that's all I'm asking for.
Mama, you're not going to believe what I saw. Not in a million thousand years. Not in a trillion million thousand years.
Yes, dear.
No, really. This is the greatest thing that everybody's been waiting for. Since I don't know when.
Well, what is it?
There's a girl in the castle.
Oh, my goodness, wouldn't that be lovely?
But there is. I saw her.
Now, Chip, I'll not have you going around making up wild stories, getting everyone's dreams up.
Mrs. Bumps, did you hear there is a girl in the castle? See, I told ya, and she's real pretty, too.
Well, I don't know about that.
This is the one, the girl we have been waiting for. She's come to break the spell.
Wait a minute, let's not be hasty.
Oh, is this wonderful? Oh, happy day.
Stop it.
She tells the others, no?
Yes. wait a minute.
No, not yet!
Please, Mama! Please, Mama!
Mama!
Mama! Mama!
that.
I'll never see him again, and I didn't even get to say goodbye.
I'll show you to your room.
My room, but I thought...
Do you want to stay in the dungeon?
No.
Then follow... You follow me. This is your home now. You're free to go anywhere you like, except the West Wing.
Why? What's in the West Wing?
It's forbidden. You are never to step foot in there, do you understand? Do you understand?
Yes.
This is your room. I hope you'll be comfortable here. If you need anything, my servants will attend you. And one more thing. You will join me for dinner. And that's not a request!
Well, what shall we dress you in for dinner? would you like to borrow one of my gowns? Let's see what I've got in my drawers. Oh, my goobers! Here we are. I wore this the night I performed at the Royal Opera. The king himself was there. But I wouldn't have a prayer fitting into it now. Take it!
That's very kind, but I'm not going to dinner.
Don't be silly. Of course you are. You heard what the master said.
He may be your master, but he's not mine. I'm sorry. This is all just happening so fast.
That was a very brave thing you did today, dear.
We all think so.
I'm just gonna miss my papa so much.
I know things look bleak right now, but you mustn't despair. We're here to see you through. I hope that we'll be friends, though I don't know you well. If anyone can make the most of living here, then Belle, it's you.
Thank you. it a big beast?
Huge!
With spooky yellow eyes?
Yes, yes!
And a long ugly snout?
Oh, hideous!
And arms are cruel fangs?
Yes, yes, definitely! Help me! Will you help me?
All right, old man, we'll help you.
Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you.
Crazy old Harry, always good for a laugh.
Get her off it! I'll go back there and get her off myself!
Crazy old Maurice. Crazy old Maurice. LaFou, I'm afraid I've been thinking.
A dangerous pastime.
I know. But that wacky old creature spells father. And to sanity's only so sound. Now the wheels in my head have been turning since I looked at that loony old man. I promised myself I'd be married to Belle, and right now I'm evolving a plan. If I...
Yes?
Then we...
No, would she?
Guess.
Now I get it. Let's go!
Where is she?
mean, circumstances being what they are.
She's not coming.
What did you
She's
say?
She's not coming.
We'll see about that.
Oh, your lordship, your grace, your eminence, let's not be hasty.
Stay where you are. Lumiere, stand aside. I told you to come down to dinner.
I'm not hungry.
I am the master of the castle, and I am telling you to come to dinner.
And I'm telling you I'm not hungry.
You're hungry if I say you're hungry.
Don't be ridiculous.
What did you say?
You can't go around ordering people to be hungry. It doesn't work like that.
I can.
Besides, it's rude.
Oh, rude, is it? Well, how about this? You don't come down to dinner, then I will drag you by the hair!
Master, that may not be the best way to win the girl's affections.
Please attempt to be a gentleman.
Why is she being so difficult? Why are you being so difficult?
Why are you being such a bully?
Because I want you to come down to dinner.
So, you admit you're being a bully.
Deep breaths, Master, deep breaths.
I'll give her one last chance. Would you be so kind as to join me for dinner? Please.
No, thank you.
Fine! Then starve!
Master, please.
If she doesn't eat with me, then she doesn't eat at all!
What were we thinking? We'll never be human again.
So it appears.
What would you two have me do? Give up? I can't give up. Not until I hear my boy's laughter as he runs through these halls again.
Quite right, Mrs. Potts. We mustn't give up as long as there's still a chance. Lumiere, stand watch at the door, and if there's the slightest change, inform me at once.
We won't go down.
I ask nicely, but she refuses. What does she want me to do? Beg? Show me the girl.
I know the master may have a fancy, but underneath all that necklace, he's really got such a bad luck. Why don't you give him a chance?
Why should I? Can I give my father a chance?
Well, no. But if you just get to know him.
I don't want to get to know him. I don't want to have anything.
Careless, wrong decision, and then that which was gone and left me in this state, an object of repulsion and derision, hated. Is there no one who can show me how to win the world's forgiveness? No. What did they say? Impress her with your wit, shower her with compliments, act like a gentleman, act like a gentleman.
Change my feelings for you. Now you really tickle my fancy.
No.
Yes.
Oh no.
Oh yes.
Oh no, no, no. I have been burned by you before.
I'll ring for Mrs. Potts and sing you an aria while we wait.
That's all right. I'll go myself.
But what about the master? He's really not going to like this.
I know.
Oh dear. Oh dear.
believe you're right.
You see, she's already starting to have a good influence on him. Oh, there you are, my dear. So glad to see you out and about.
I am Cogsworth, head of the household.
Cogsworth, the girl, she's gone. I swear my eyes never left her.
Enchanté, mademoiselle. This is Lumiere. Oh, stop that, stop it. If there's anything we can do to make your stay here more comfortable, anything at all.
I am a little hungry.
Except that.
Cogsworth!
Well, you heard what the master said.
Pish posh. I'll not have this child go hungry.
Fine. Glass of water, crust of bread, and then right off to bed.
Cogsworth, I'm surprised at you. She's not a prisoner. She's our guest. We must make her feel welcome here.
All right, dinner. But keep it down. If the master finds out, it'll be our necks.
Of course, of course. But what is dinner without a little music?
Music?
Mon cher, mademoiselle, it is with deepest pride and greatest pleasure that we welcome you tonight. And so, we invite you to relax. Let us pull up a chair as the dining room proudly presents your dinner.
Be our guest.
Be our guest. Put our service to the test. Tie a napkin around your neck, sherry, and we'll provide service. Soup to show, hot orders, why? We only live to serve. Try the great stuff.
It's delicious!
Don't believe me. Ask the dishes. Second sing, second dance. After all, this is his part.
And dinner here is never second dance.
Come on and vote ya. Then you'll take a glance at. Then you'll be our guest. We are guests. We are guests.
Eat red goo and cheese souffle. Pie and pulling it up the
tree. We prepare and serve with flair a culinary cabaret.
You're alone.
Nervy. to a servant who's not serving. He's not bold without a soul to it harm. Ah, those good old days when we were useful. Suddenly, those good old days are gone. 10 years we've been rusting, needing so much walls and dusting, needing exercise, a chance to use our skills. Those days we just lay around the castle. Flat, fat, and lazy, you walked in.
Well, this will be good. Oh, Belle. Belle.
Now, if you will note the unusual inverted arches, you will see that this is yet another example of the late neoclassic Baroque period. And, as I always say, if it's not Baroque, don't fix it. May I draw your attention? attention to the flying buttresses above the aviary.
Oh, Lumiere, it's all so beautiful. I had no idea. If only he weren't here.
Oh. Act like a gentleman. I am nothing but a fool.
And thanks to some quick thinking on my part, the disaster was averted. And that was the last time a stone of that weight was quarried in this area.
What's up there?
Nothing! Nothing at all of any interest in the West Wing.
So that's the West Wing.
Nice going.
I wonder what he's hiding up there.
Hiding? What an idea, hiding.
Well, then it wouldn't be forbidden, would it?
Perhaps Mademoiselle would like to see something else. We have some exquisite tapestries dating all the way back to Aloysius the Pretentious.
Maybe later.
Perhaps you'd like to see the gardens or the library.
You have a library?
With books.
Oh, yes, lots of books. Mountains of books, forests of books, cascades, cloudbursts, swamps of books.
Books with pictures, books with words.
And more words than you could ever be able to read in a lifetime.
Books by every author on every subject, every author has been killed by fear.
Thank you.
do that. Just hold still.
Ow! That hurt.
If you would hold still, it wouldn't hurt as much.
Well, none of this would have happened if you hadn't run away.
If you hadn't frightened me, I wouldn't have run away.
Well, you shouldn't have been in the West Wing.
And you should learn to control your temper. Now hold still. This may sting a little. By the way, thank you for saving my life.
You're welcome.
It's more like it. I knew they'd get along if they just tried.
So, the ice is broken at last.
And not a moment too soon, either. Have you taken a good look at the rose lately? It's losing petals at an alarming rate.
Not to mention, I can barely bend over anymore.
Clearly, it is time for us to give them a little push. We must find a nice romantic way to help draw them closer together.
I have just the thing. How about we warm you two up with a nice bowl of soup?
Soup?
Trust me.
There's something sweet and almost kind. He was mean and he was coarse and unrefined. And now he's dear and so unsure. I wonder why I didn't see it there before.
Come along, dearie, let's get you out of those wet things.
She glanced this way, I thought I saw. When we touched, she didn't shudder at my paw. No, it can't be, I'll just ignore. But then she's never looked at me that way before. When she smiles at me, I get all choked up inside. My heart starts pounding and I can't breathe.
Good.
That's good.
That's not bad.
I never felt this way about anyone. I want to give her something. But what?
Well, there's the usual things. Flowers, chocolates, promises you don't intend to keep.
No. This is no ordinary girl. It must be something special. Something that sparks her interest. Something...
What? Are you sure?
Say something about the dress.
It's pink.
A compliment!
Oh, what a nice dress.
Thank you.
Well, I have something to show you. But first you have to close your eyes. It's a surprise.
That's a girl! Oh.
Long ago.
Well, it just so happened. perfect book to read aloud. Come here, sit by me.
Well, who'd have thought?
Bless my soul.
Well, who'd have known?
Well, who indeed?
And who'd have guessed they'd come together, arms at all?
It's so peculiar.
Wait and see, a few days more. There may be something there that wasn't there before.
Perhaps there's something there that wasn't there before.
What?
There may be something there that wasn't there before.
What's there, Mama?
Shh, I'll tell you when you're older.
Mama?
Yes, Chip?
Will I ever get to be a boy again?
I hope so.
When will I know?
Soon. If it's up to me, it will be very soon now. Come on, let's give them some privacy.
Knowing not that this was indeed the legendary sword called Excalibur, Arthur tried to pull it from the stone. He tried once, to no avail. He tried a second time, but still he could not pull it out. Then, for the third time, Arthur drew forth the sword.
So that must mean he's king.
Wait and see.
I never knew books could do that.
Do what?
Take me away from this place and make me forget for a little while.
Forget?
Who I... what I am.
We have something in common, you know.
What?
In the town where I come from, the people think I'm odd.
You?
So I know how it feels to be different. I know how lonely that can be. For the third time, Arthur drew forth the sword, and there arose from the people a great shout. Arthur is king.
Told you so.
Door.
Please don't bring him in late. Or In my sword, it's a no.
So put the church priest's glasses high.
I don't think I can do that.
You must.
You care for the girl, don't you?
More than anything.
Then tell her.
I can't.
You must.
There will be beautiful music, romantic candlelight provided by myself. And then, when the moment is right.
Oh, how will I know when the moment is right?
You'll feel slightly nauseous.
You will know. Because you will feel it here. And then you must speak from the heart.
I must speak from... No, I can't.
You must. What are you afraid of?
Oh, nothing.
Master?
I'm afraid she might...
She might what?
Laugh at me.
Somehow, my prince, you must find the courage to take the chance.
Master, look at the rose. There's so little time left.
I really don't think I can do this.
Here, take a look in the mirror. That may bolster your confidence. Huh? You can do it, Master. I know you can.
Thank you.
send me to dinner.
It was wonderful.
Belle, I...
Yes?
Belle, are you happy here?
Oh, yes. Everyone is so kind. Mrs. Potts, Lumiere.
With me?
Yes.
I must speak from
the heart.
Is something wrong?
I was just thinking about my father. I miss him so much. I wish I could see him again.
There is a way. This mirror will show you anything you wish to see.
Your father.
Gaston, you know he's not crazy.
I might be able to clear up this little misunderstanding if...
If what?
If you marry me.
What?
Just one little word, Belle, that's all it takes.
Never.
Have it your way. Take the old man.
Let go of me!
Wait!
Let go of me.
Wait!
No!
I can prove my father's not crazy. Show me the beast.
That's him! That's him!
Is it dangerous?
No, he would never hurt anyone. I know he looks frightful, but he's really very kind and gentle. He's my friend.
If I didn't know any better, I'd say you had feelings for this monster.
He's not the monster, Gaston. You are.
She's as crazy as the old man. She says this creature is her friend. Well, I've hunted wild beasts, and I've seen what they can do. The beast will make off with your children.
No!
He'll come after them in the night.
No, he would never do that.
Forget the old man. I say we kill the beast.
Yeah.
We're not safe until he's dead.
He'll come stalking us at night.
He's set to sacrifice our children to his monstrous appetites.
Yeah!
kind and gentle to fight back. You are in love with her, aren't you, beast? Ha ha, that's a good one. Do you really think a girl like that would want to stay like you? What a fool. She despises you, beast, and she's just here to destroy you.
No!
It's over, beast. Bell is mine.
Recognize the beast within the man who's here before you. It is you?
Stop it. The spell is broken. We're human again.
You here? Come here. Cogsworth! My Cogsworth! Let's go find your father.
Who was that young man?
The prince!
No, it wasn't.
Yes, it was.
No, it wasn't.
It most certainly was.
Mama? Mama? Chip? Oh, Chip!